So, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to a Health Science Academy white coat ceremony for the class of 2023. Today's agenda, we're gonna begin with, well, we're gonna follow in this welcome here and review of the agenda. We're gonna go to Mr. Hector Gonzalez, our HWAP coordinator, who's gonna do the Zoom etiquette. Then we're gonna pass it along to Dr. Marilyn Fraser, our CEO, and she's going to introduce Dr. James Cottrell, who is our featured address speaker today. That's going to be followed by an introduction of the institute, as well as staff, an alumni testimonial video, the history and symbolism of the white coat, a demonstration of the white coat, and then the highlight of the day where our students put on their white coats, followed by a slideshow, the recital of the Hippocratic Oath, and then closing remarks by Dr. Mary Valmont, our Associate Executive Director. So, Mr. Gonzalez.
Hi everyone. Sorry, I was just unmuting myself. Some Zoom etiquette. So we want to just kind of touch some ground rules as we progress through the ceremony. So please make sure that you have a clean, work-appropriate background, like you do when you're in the Health Science Academy. Please turn on all your cameras. We want to see your faces. Limit distractions. Mute your microphone if you're not speaking. You won't need to speak, so you can just have those muted. And as informed, when you log on, please note that this session will be recorded and is currently being recorded. As outlined and signed in the HSA application part two, photos taken will be used for the Institute's promotion via social media or any other forms of media at Institute's discretion. Enjoy.
Now we pass it over to Dr. Fraser, who's going to introduce Dr. Cottrell. Dr. Fraser.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. It's so wonderful to see all of you online. And it's amazing that we are able to do this amidst everything that we have gone through over the past year. Usually, we would have had a white coat ceremony in person, and because of everything that has happened, we are doing it virtually. And we still think of it as something important, and we would like to just welcome you officially again to the Health Science Academy. We thank you for coming on this journey with us. It is something that is important. We think of you as a special group of students, and we look forward to your being with us and working throughout the 3 years that you are doing this. And we would like to thank your parents. We like to thank those guardians. We like to thank your teachers and all of those that have come through with you along this journey. We have a great staff at the Health Science Academy and the Arthur Ashe Institute, and they're there to help you. They're there to help you along this journey that you have embarked upon. And many of you came in thinking of medicine or nursing, and there's so many other fields that you can pursue. And we just want you to know that we are here to help you and assist you along that path. And we hope to hear great things from you. That you've come to the academy, you should congratulate yourselves that you are at this stage of your career and you're thinking about greater and brighter things. And we are there along the journey with you. This afternoon, I have just the esteemed pleasure to introduce you to your keynote speaker, so to speak. And he's Dr. Cottrell. Dr. Cottrell is very well respected and very well recognized. So Dr. James Cottrell, something that you may not know about him. He is the former chair, a chair emeritus of the Department of Anesthesiology at SUNY Downstate Health Sciences University. But before that, Dr. Cottrell has been quite busy. He has done a lot in his career. He has authored a lot of books, co-authored articles. He has mentored many hundreds of students, and he's mentored residents, and he's also served as a regent for New York State as well. Dr. Cottrell has also served in the military, in the Navy, and Dr. Cottrell, I've been told that he likes art, and he's an avid collector of art. But one of the things that stands out most for me with Dr. Cottrell is his humility and his kindness. And he's just a wonderful person to be around and a fun person also to be around. And in 2016, we had the pleasure of honoring him with an Arthur Ashe Leadership Award. So this afternoon, I really would like to thank Dr. Cottrell for being here. One of the things that he has done for many years is provided the white coats that you have the pleasure of using this evening and the white coats that you will use throughout your 3 years in the academy. And he has done that for many years. So without further ado, I would like to introduce you to Dr. James Cottrell, and I would like to introduce you to this friend of the Arthur Ashe Institute, Dr. Cottrell.
Thank you, Dr. Frazier, and congratulations, class of 2023, all of you, for supporting the legacy of Arthur Ashe by being here this evening. It's a special honor for me to be included with the Health Science Academy class of 2023. Your families, the Arthur Ashe Institute for Urban Health staff, and guests for this celebration. It's an honor for me to see you receive your white coats during this ceremony. My favorite part of the Arthur Ashe Institute for Urban Health is the Arthur Ashe Health Science Academy, because the Health Science Academy gives high school and middle school students who could only dream of becoming a doctor, another healthcare professional, a path to make that dream come true. Had it not been for a similar program that was briefly funded in West Virginia during the 1950s, a program that helped small town kids who wanted to major in science, I would still be Jim Cottrell, but I would not be Dr. Cottrell. And I would not be here today speaking to you if it weren't for that support. That program changed the course of my life, as I hope you will allow the Health Science Academy to change yours. I also love the Health Science Academy because it addresses a problem that Arthur Ashe knew well, discrimination. When Arthur Ashe was a boy in Richmond, Virginia, he was not allowed to play tennis against white people in tennis tournaments. And after that barrier was broken, more often than not, he played as the lone African-American in a sea of white players. I don't really know what it's like to be a victim of racial discrimination, but unfortunately, there are many forms of prejudice. And I do know how it felt to be the only gay young man from a small town in West Virginia, immersed in a sea of people with conventional orientations and 1950s attitudes towards those of us who had different orientations. When Arthur died in 1993, African Americans composed 13% of the population, but they were only 2 to 3% of American physicians. The bad news is that those figures have changed very little. That's what the Health Science Academy aims to fix by offering training to underrepresented high school and middle school students who want to pursue a career in science and/or the medical professions. About 2,700 of you since 1994, with most being Black and female. You and the Health Science Academy will work to change that through the advanced training you'll receive over the next 3 years, which will prepare you to pursue college, graduate school, and a career in science and other medical professions. Most Health Science Academy graduates enroll in college the year after they leave the academy, with almost 65% graduating with a health science degree. The national average for completion of an undergraduate degree is 6 years, but the Health Science Academy, you do it in 4 years. Tonight, it is my honor to also speak about one of Health Science Academy's success stories. Dr. Joshua McHugh started with the Health Science Academy during his 9th grade at Nazareth High School. He had aced his regents and was interested in science. He completed the program in 2004, was accepted at Haverford College, and graduated from Downstate Medical School in 2012. He accepted a residency in emergency medicine at Downstate. After that, he completed a simulator training fellowship. He then joined the Mount Sinai Medical School, where he is currently working to reverse healthcare disparities. He also organizes fundraisers to acquire educational supplies to benefit the homeless and socioeconomically disadvantaged children. He also coordinates clothing drives for the homeless patients in the emergency department at Mount Sinai. Joshua would probably not be Dr. Joshua McHugh had it not been for the early boost he got from the Health Science Academy of the Arthur Ashe Institute. Dr. McHugh and I have had the privilege of serving underprivileged patients in Manhattan and Brooklyn. We also have the privilege of teaching students from all walks of life. Thanks to the Arthur Ashe Health Science Academy, more and more of those students are African American who were born and raised in Brooklyn. Again, thank you for being here this evening, and thank you for continuing to support the Arthur Ashe Institute for Urban Health and the Health Science Academy. Best wishes and congratulations again to the class of 2023.
Thank you, Dr. Cattrall. Thank you, we really appreciate it. Now we're gonna, I'm just gonna give you a brief as to who Arthur Ashe is. As you've heard, Dr. Cattrall just spoke a lot about Arthur Ashe. And as most of us know, he was an American professional tennis player who won multiple Grand Slams, but he wasn't just a great athlete only. He was also a great person off the course because he was a social activist. He, other than being the first person to, you know, go to the United States Davis Cup, being the only Black man ever to win the singles Wimbledon title and the US Open and the Australian Open, we saw his activism out in the open when he fought for Haitian refugees. Also, as part of the South African apartheid, his role he played in that, as well as when he went ahead to, you know, found the Arthur Ashe Institute and the Arthur Ashe Foundation before he died from AIDS. So as we all know, we just want to recognize Arthur Ashe, because without him, there wouldn't be an Arthur Ashe Institute and Arthur Ashe, the Health Science Academy. So who are we, the Arthur Ashe Institute? As you may or may not know, we're a community-based nonprofit organization that partners with SUNY Downstate Health Sciences University to design, incubate, and replicate neighborhood-based interventions that address health conditions disproportionately affecting minorities. We are health professionals, public health professionals, academics, creatives, community members, and activists. We're passionate about community health empowerment, and we're dedicated to Arthur's vision for equality in healthcare for all. We continue Arthur's vision through our community engagement and research department and the Health Science Academy Pipeline Program. So I just want to introduce the different staff members. So members of HSA staff, as I call your name, please wave so participants know who you are. So Dr. Mary Valmont, she is our Associate Executive Director for the Health Science Education.
Good evening and welcome.
I am Janelle Williams, and I'm the Senior Education Coordinator of the Health Science Academy. Then we have Mr. Hector Gonzalez, who is the HCOP Education Coordinator. Mr. Kenneth Zen, who's an education coordinator, but he's also an alumni who came through right through the program, alumni, volunteer, intern, and he's now education coordinator. And our recently new education coordinator, we have Miss Tiffany James. So this is the Health Science Academy team. But in addition to that, we are one family at the Institute. So I want to introduce everyone else was part of the Institute. I noticed we have our board member, our board chairman, Mr. Brett Wright. So we just want to welcome and acknowledge Mr. Wright for being here and with us today. We also have Ms. Faven Araya, who is the Community Engagement and Research Program Manager. So Community Engagement Research, you can also wave as well. We have Mr. Sean Mitchell, who is the Senior Program Coordinator of Community Engagement and Research. And we also have Ms. Erica Sai Savani, who is our social media consultant, and Ms. Meryl Ahoranian, Ms. Meryl Black Ahoranian, who is also a consultant for the Health Science Academy. So we're a team putting all of this together. So I just want to say thank you to the team, and thank you and welcome for being with us here. So we just want to note that usually at this point, HSA staff, normally we will go over the academy guidelines. However, this was done last fall at your sophomore orientation. To date, each student has signed the academy guideline for the 2020-2021 school year. So please know that we will have you and your parents sign this every fall. And if you have any questions on any of the Academy guidelines, please feel free not just to contact myself only, but any other member of the HSA staff, Ms. James, Mr. Gonzalez, or Mr. Zen. So we're now going to get into our white coat ceremony. So history and symbolism of the white coat. Basically, white coat ceremonies typically involve a formal robing or cloaking of students in white coat. Although traditionally physicians have worn white coats for over 100 years and other health professions have adopted it, the white coat ceremony itself only started in the early 1990s. And as was previously mentioned by Dr. Fraser, typically we conduct our white coat ceremony along with our sophomore orientation in August. However, we delayed your ceremony because of the COVID-19 pandemic, and we're hoping to be back in person. We were hoping to be back in person by now, but we're here on Zoom, but we're still grateful for that. White coat ceremony typically address the issue of medical ethics and praise rising students for their success in completing the basic science coursework. And that's a wide range. So we have medicine, advanced practice nursing, pharmacy, physical therapy, occupational therapy. So there isn't a limit to it. Over 100 medical schools in the US now have a white coat ceremony, and many students now consider it a rite of passage in the journey towards a healthcare career. This is our class of 2022 at their white coat ceremony, which was the last in-person white coat ceremony that we had. So now we're going to have a live demonstration. Mr. Zen and Ms. James, they're going to show you how to put on the white coat. They're going to show you the correct way to put it on, but if you are doing it yourself and if you have a family member or friend assisting you. After the demonstration, Dr. Valmont will direct you to stand and put on your white coat. So now we're now going to pay attention to Mr. Zen and Ms. James as they show us how to put on the white coats. Mr. Zen, can you say hello so I can just pin your screen?
Hello, everybody.
And this is the way that you put on your white coat. If someone is putting on the white coat for you, and then you go ahead and you can button it up. Thank you, Mr. Zen. Now, Mr. Zen or Ms. James, would you demonstrate how to put on your white coat if you were to do it on your own, if you don't have a family member with you to put it on for you?
I got it.
Thank you, Mr. Zen. Clearly, you're familiar with it. You've been doing it as an HSA student, alumni, and soon as a medical student. So you're good at it. So before we get to Dr. Valmont and the students putting on their white coats, we're just going to ask our board chairman, Mr. Wright, to just give a few words, please. Brief remarks.
Very brief, very brief. Hello, everybody. Very glad to be here with you. This is probably my 10th white coat ceremony, I think. So on behalf of the board and the staff, I want to thank you and congratulate you for taking part in this very, very exciting opportunity. There are so many things going on specifically around health issues currently. So you guys are on the right path. I wish they had programs like this when I was a kid. I maybe would have been a doctor. So it's a very exciting time. Parents, I really appreciate you guys being on here to support your children. There's a lot of opportunities to come along with this. And Marilyn, for your leadership in pulling this together. There are definitely trying times, but you guys will persevere. There's a reason why we have these challenges in front of us. They don't put anything in front of us that we can't get over. So this is the first step. Enjoy and wear those white coats proudly, and make the most of this program. So like I said, I'm gonna keep it brief. I'm glad you guys could be a part of this program. Congratulations, put in the work, and it will all pay off. So congratulations again, and have a good night.
Thank you, Mr. Wright. And we also want to acknowledge all our high school partner liaisons and our middle school liaisons as well, who are present here to witness your white coat ceremony, along with our alumni, because we have a few alumni who are here just to show their support to you as well. So we want to acknowledge their presence here as well. Dr. V.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Mary Valmont, and it is very exciting to be here. Earlier today, when we went through the practice, I found it maybe surprisingly emotional. As Ms. Williams said, we usually do this in August, along with your sophomore orientation. And way back in the summer, which seemed like a very long time ago, we were very optimistic that we would be back in person by now, which is why we delayed it. And I think it was a hard decision for us to realize that we had to go ahead, because this is, to us, an important part of your transition, part of welcoming you into the Health Science Academy. So I have to say, despite the butterflies and hoping that we can see you in person very soon, I'm very glad to be here and to take you through this. So I'm going to ask all of you students to stand up again, as you just saw by that demo. If you're by yourself, you know, you'll put the jacket on by yourself. If someone that you're with, a family member, a friend, they should help you into the jacket without, and I don't mean this, we've done this when we do this in person, it's not as easy as you think it is to put a jacket on somebody. That's why we had the demo. So I'm going to count to five, and if you could stand up and prepare yourself to put your jackets on. One, two, three, four, five. So all the students should be standing. If someone's there to help you with your jacket, please have your jacket unbuttoned. Please put it on. Again, because of the joys of remoteness in Zoom, we can only see about maybe 25 squares at a time. We are taking screenshots and pictures of this. I'm trying to figure out how actually will I know what everybody, you can go ahead and put your go ahead and put your coat on, or if someone's with you, they can put the coat on for you, right? Is everyone, oh my God, there's six pages, wow. My staff, can you let me know whether it seems like most people have their lab coats on? I'm kind of going through this. It looks like most students do. Okay. Everyone looks very handsome and or beautiful, and we're very proud of you. Again, we are taking screenshots. That's why I'm asking you to stand for a couple of seconds before we go on to the next slide. Could you please stand? It makes it easier to take a picture. Thank you. Ms. Williams, you think we have everybody?
Mr. Zen and Mr. Gonzalez, do we have everyone?
We're still missing some folks. Again, guys, if you don't have your video on, we highly, highly encourage you guys to have your turn your camera on, so you can just take part of this moment.
Yes, if you are a student, you please show yourself, because we will not be able to see you in your fabulous lab coat without you being on camera.
And remember to smile.
Oh yes, that would be helpful. So, and because you don't have the mask on, we could actually see your smile. versus when you come to downstate with the mask on. Okay, so I think everyone, for the most part, who's visible seems to be standing with a coat on. I'm assuming everyone else who's not showing a camera is not a student, I hope. Okay, again, thank you. We're about to show you a video, but you may sit down and then we will proceed to this video.
So again, congratulations, class of 2020.
Congratulations. Let's give everyone a round of applause. You can unmute yourself.
Go, Naya. Woo!
All right, Susie.
Congratulations. Yes, ma'am. Samantha.
Congratulations, Lauren.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Susie, we're so proud of you, Susie.
Congratulations,
Lauren.
We love you.
Okay. Congratulations, Lauren.
Congratulations, Lauren.
Thank you.
So you're now going to see a video of when most of you came to downstate last week. Thank you very much for making the journey.
Congratulations, Susan.
And this is a video of
Go Susie, go Susie, go Susie.
Divided up by school.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it. I'm facing the chances I'm taking. Sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most. Yeah, just gotta keep going.
Again, congratulations, class of 2023. Right. So, as is customary with all white coat ceremonies, we say the Hippocratic Oath. And just a brief history on it, it's an oath that is historically taken by physicians. It is one of the most widely known of Greek medical texts. In its original form, it requires a new physician to swear by a number of healing gods to uphold specific ethical standards. Of historic and traditional value, the oath is considered a rite of passage for practitioners of medicine in many countries. So not only do physicians, but also nurses, different physical therapists, different medical groups, during their white coat ceremonies, they recite the Hippocratic Oath. So you're going to repeat after me. We're going to do this line by line. And we're going to take our time and do it. So please repeat after me. I swear to fulfill to the best of my ability.
I swear to fulfill.
You can't be back in community. Come on.
On scientific gains of those physicians in whose steps
Excuse me, time out.
Ms. Williams, this is a challenge. This is the first time we've done this virtual. We're getting so much feedback. I don't think it works. I think people can say it, but they should perhaps stay muted. What do you think, Ms. Williams?
I think one suggestion is just have one person repeat after you. Select a student and have that person repeat after you while everyone else is muted. Everyone else is muted, and then they can say it. They can say it in their own homes, but just have one person be unmuted and repeat after you, Ms. Williams.
I agree. And the first person that shows up on my screen is Oatmeal. So Oatmeal, you'll repeat after me.
And everybody else, stay muted, but please say it.
Yes.
That's a great idea. So we'll start over. I swear to fulfill to the best of my ability and judgment this covenant.
I swear to fulfill to the best of my ability and judgment this covenant.
I will respect the hard-won scientific gains of those physicians.
I will respect the hard-won scientific gain of those physicians.
Steps I walk and gladly share.
As I walk and gladly share.
Such knowledge as is mine.
Such knowledge as mine.
Those who are to follow.
With those who are to follow.
I will apply for the benefit of the sick.
I will apply for the benefit of the sick.
Measures which are required.
All measures which are required.
Warding those twin traps of over-treatment.
Wait, so what?
Avoiding those twin traps of over-treatment.
For those treatment.
And therapeutic nihilism.
Wait, I can't hear you. Say what?
And therapeutic off the screen. It's on the PowerPoint.
Yay, Mimi.
I will remember that there is art to medicine.
I will remember that there is art to medicine,
as well as science, and that warmth, sympathy, and understanding,
outweigh
the surgeon's knife. Or the chemist's drug.
I will not be ashamed to say.
I fail to call in my colleagues. When the skills of another are needed. For a patient's recovery. I will respect the privacy of my patients. Their problems are not disclosed to me. That the world may know.
Can you move to the next slide?
Most especially must I treat with care.
With care.
In matters of life and death.
And matter of life and death. If it is given to me to save a life.
All thanks. But it may also be within my power to take a life. This awesome responsibility.
Must be faced with great humbleness.
And awareness of my own frailty.
Above all.
I must not play at God. I will remember that I do not treat a fever chart.
A cancerous growth.
But a sick human being. Whose illness may affect the person's family. And economic stability. My responsibility includes
These related problems.
If I am to care adequately for the sick. I will prevent disease whenever I can.
For prevention is preferable to cure.
I will remember that I remain a member of society.
With special obligation to all my fellow human beings.
Those sound of mind and body. As well as the infirm. If I do not violate this oath. May I enjoy life and art.
Respected while I live.
And remembered with affection thereafter. May I always act so as to preserve. The finest tradition of my calling.
May I long experience the joy of healing.
Those who seek my help.
God will seek my help.
So thank you, O'Neill, for walking us through the Hippocratic Oath. And thank you to all the students who were saying the Hippocratic Oath at the same time as O'Neill recited it. We will now
have a round of applause because he did not know we were going to choose him. So let's unmute ourselves and thank him.
Hi, applause.
Yay, my man.
Very good job, O'Neill, for being put on the spot. Now we have an alumni testimonial from Marco Diaz Garovo. Marco is an HSL alum 2012. He's currently a year two medical student here at SUNY Dong State College of Medicine. And he's also one of our past instructors, as well as intern and volunteer. So Marco just has a few words for you.
Hey guys, welcome. My name is Marco Diaz Cordova. I graduated from the Arthur Ashe Institute for Urban Health, Health Science Academy back in 2012. In 2009, I was in your same spot and I was very, very nervous. However, my piece of advice to you is to please enjoy, try to take as much advantage as possible and be involved with the Academy as much as possible. Everybody at the Academy, starting from Dr. Bauman to Ms. Williams, Mr. Gonzalez to Mr. Kenner, are there to help you, support you, and guide you. Right away, you might not see the benefits. However, in the long term, the benefits from the Academy are immeasurable. So good luck, Welcome and congratulations.
Thank you, Marco. We just want to say thank you, Marco.
Hey, guys. Welcome.
Sharing that with us. And we're to the end of our ceremony, and Dr. V is going to leave us with some closing remarks. Dr. Valmont.
Thank you. Wow. This is the challenge of when we do things remotely. They're always faster than you think. That was a lot of things in a very short time. I didn't actually prepare any remarks. I was feeling very emotional through the whole thing. But again, we're very proud of everyone who is here. I hope you appreciate the significance of this day. Right now, we're all looking for some kind of anchor, some kind of symbolism. And I think that the ceremony, the white coat ceremony, which again is kind of a formal introduction to the Health Science Academy, is hopefully something that you can anchor yourself to for the next 2.5 years that we are with you. Again, for my staff and myself, this is all very new to us. We have not actually met most of you in person. My staff was at Downstate last week, got to meet those of you who came in for the pictures, but we hope that by the fall, the start of your second of your 3 years with us, we will be able to resume in-person classes of all the wonderful hands-on things like animal dissections and labs. But in the meantime, we value you. We appreciate the efforts that the students are making to stay engaged with remote learning. We know it's not easy. We're adults and it's not easy for us to remain engaged on Zoom meeting after Zoom meeting. So we know it's particularly challenging. We are here for you, as Dr. Frazier said in the beginning. We have much to offer you. I hope you will do everything you can to take advantage of this wonderful opportunity. Again, congratulations. And like Marco Diaz, again, who's now in his second year here at Downstate Medical School, we hope that whatever your healthcare futures are, that you really relish being here at the Health Science Academy and you enjoy it. And thank you very much to my team. They put together this wonderful PowerPoint, so I want a round of applause for them also. And thank you, and we'll also, Ms. Williams, you should mention that we'll be able to make the recording available if people want it, and we will put the program in the chat box if it hasn't already been put in. But thank you, have a good evening, and we will see you all next week back at Academy Classes.
So thank you, Dr.
Congratulations
Lee.
Again, Susie.
Congratulations, Susie. We're proud of you.
Congratulations, Dr. Whaley.
Let's get to work. Let's go.
Congratulations, Nicole.
Julius said, let's get to work. Let's go.
Congratulations, Norman Whaley.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Nicole.
Everyone looks really beautiful, handsome, and beautiful in your lab coats. Congratulations again. To the future doctors and nurses, way to go.
Is it lowering me? I don't know.
Have a good night, everyone. See you guys next week. Congratulations.
Enjoy your weekend. Congratulations, Lauren.
Good night. Yes, yes.
Good night.
Night.
Bye. Susie!
Bye, Woo! Bye, Steph.
Thank you again, O'Neal. Thank you.
You're welcome. I was kind of, I don't know what's going on. I was kind of nervous a little bit, but then I take a deep breath, you know, I guess. Because I didn't even see the part that you were telling me. So I was kind of nervous, but I was like, I got this.
It's Miss Williams' favorite saying, you got this.
Stay safe.
You did a great job.
You did a great job. My staff, I'm going to ask you to stay on when everyone's gone just to do a quick debrief.
And thank you to the other Dung State staff that was here with us, Dr. Allen, Dr. Taylor, and anyone that I may have missed. Thank you as well for joining us.
I think I saw Ms. Hill from Brooklyn Generation, our liaison. I think I saw Ms. Moore of Benjamin Banneker. Also staff people. Ms. Leanne Hicks was here at one point. I typed so slowly, by the time I tried to type out a hello, the moment had passed.
Hi, Tamita.
Thank you again, Dr. Cottrell and Dr. Frazier.
Thanks, Mary.
Thank you.
Hi, Mr. Whaley.
He upside down on one thing.
Hi, Mama Whaley.
Someone's upside down.
Okay. I didn't know what happened there.
You.
It's okay now.